Thanks to everyone who have subscribed. If you have not, please do. And thanks for coming out here. I really appreciate you.
Fresh crisis looms in Edo APC as plots to unseat Godwin Obaseki takes a new dimension. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time we're reaching you today. I want to say a big thank you for your huge and massive support. Thanks for always being there. We sincerely, truly, really appreciate you. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe and give us a thumbs up. Thanks and God bless. Well, my people, we are reporting you live as the issues and the matters are coming up. Edo State election is quite an interesting one with regards to all the situations that surrounds Edo State, talking about the person of the governor and the former governor, Godwin Obaseki. There are issues looming up in the elections to come, as there are factions already, some loyal to Obaseki, others loyal to Adams Oshiomhole. Well, let's get into the news and get all the details. It is no longer news that the Edo State chapter of the APC has been boiling in crisis. The battle between the current governor and the national chairman has divided the party into factions within the state. However, a fresh crisis looms, the kind that can only be explained with what happened in Zamfara experience if care is not taken. According to the captain, Mohammed Jubrim, the pioneer deputy national auditor of the party, serious constitutional breaches need to be addressed, and he has called on the NEC of the party to intervene speedily before the commencement of the state primaries to avoid a Zamfara state equality in Edo State. He said the NEC is the only constitutional body that has the final say on the issue at hand. This means that to roll back the crawling in This means that to roll back the creeping improportionalities and lawlessness, NEC should summon an emergency meeting and thrash out the issues once and for all. The contemplation of the draft of the APC constitution is that direct primaries means allowing all cards carrying party members to vote in a primary election. However, there are two issues that, unless addressed, the whole exercise will be subject to abuse and manipulation. First, not every party member can vote or be voted for under Article 9.3, Section 1. Stated that only fully registered and financially up-to-date members of the party should have the right to vote and to be voted for into any elective position or office. Subject to the provision made for such election, purchase of this constitution or other laws or regulations. Consequently, non-financial members should not enjoy the above rights. How do you verify under this situation who is financially committed? Consequently, non-financial members should not enjoy the above rights. How do you verify under these circumstances who is the financial member and who has been financially committed? In the last election, APC lost Zamfara and subsequently Bayelsa as a result of inconsistency during the screening process of the primaries. Meanwhile, the plot to unseat the incumbent governor of the state thickens. This time, it is taking a whole new dimension, as the incumbent has been accused of certificate forgery, a claim that the incumbent has roughly dismissed. He has made a statement to that the university is there. The university can be reached for his certificate. According to the Daily Times, a member of the National Working Committee of the party has spoken in anonymous, say that there are serious discrepancies in the forms and all the documents submitted by some of the aspirants. He said, except a divine intervention or call, the screening process could screen out Godwin Obaseki, and as such, great cautions and measures should be taken. Meanwhile, whole screening process has commenced earnestly in Edo State. We just pray that Edo State does the right thing and the incumbent governor and Godwin Obaseki and Oshiomhole work together to sort out this problem so we don't go the way of other states that APC has lost. Well, my people, you've heard it all. They said the plot to unseat Godwin Obaseki with regards to certificate forgery is still being taken up, and this could lead to him being screened out in the screening process. Although we also reported live with regards to that Godwin Obaseki has cleared the air. He said he finished from University of Ibadan, and University of Ibadan is just around the corner. Anybody can actually go there and verify from the department that he graduated from, if really he was an alumni of the school. And I think that is a fair statement to say, because I mean, University of Ibadan is not in Toronto, is not in America, is not in the UK, is not in Canada, is in Nigeria there. And so verification can be made rather than assumption and wild guesses, wild goose chase. Well, it's time for APC to sit up so as not to go the way of Zamfara, like some, you know, like the statement has been going. APC government needs to know what they are doing. The persons, the like of the chairman, Adams Oshiomhole, needs to put himself together to make sure that his party is not just about himself, or it's not just about himself and Adams Oshiomhole and Godwin Obaseki. Is about the party. Don't forget that in the South alone, APC has lost how many states? You don't want to add those states to it. The truth of the matter is that they are not realizing that the elections is not just between APCs. It's not an APC election and that's it. No, the election is beyond just APC members. The election is generally, because after APC has carried out their primaries, there is still going to be the September 19 election. And if APC does not do their due diligence, they might miss out. Because you can be surprised that some people might want to even play dirty and support the opposition against APC. So that's what we are talking about, that they need to sit up and get their acts together. Working and feeling like you own the whole election process. See, even if INEC declares that APC has won the election, another party can take APC, the governor who has won, to court. That's why they need to stop spreading their dirty linen in the marketplace and get on with moving forward and making sure that they don't expose themselves beyond what they should. APC has already lost Zamfara, has already lost Bayelsa, and if they are not careful, don't forget that PDP in this matter is an underdog, waiting at the slightest of moments to overtake. We're not talking about party here, whether APC, PDP. We are talking about good governance in Nigeria. Enough of people trying to, you know, just play on our intelligence and just tell us that we will give you this, give you that, bamboozle us and make us feel that they are working at it to get the elections sorted out. And really, actually, they are not doing anything. They are not doing anything to make sure that the Nigerian people and the economy, you know, look, gets better. They are not working at it at all. They come in every minute telling us that they are working at it to see to it that there is good electricity, there is road, there is power, there is this and there is that. But really and truly, are they doing it? Are they doing it? Are they working in that regard? My people, the election is beyond Obaseki and Oshiomhole. It's beyond APC. Other parties are going to get involved. And guess what? If APC does not get themselves together, you saw what happened in Bayelsa State. Yes. INEC said they have won. According to INEC, in fact, the governor was already putting party together, celebration and winning party together. But guess what? Court case was around the corner. Court case was around the corner. We threw them out of office. So what are we talking about? What are we talking about? The matter continues. It's not enough for INEC to tell you that you have won. It's not enough. It's not enough. That's why APC needs to get themselves together and stop fighting one another. And look at it truly and really. Do I have a chance of not just winning the primaries, but winning the whole state at large? If APC wants to continue the work they have started right from the time of Oshiomhole to Obaseki's first tenure, APC needs to get themselves together, because now the plot is to take away the incumbent governor and to, you know, rubbish him. But don't forget that everything you are putting out there, PDP is picking it up, and we face you in court if anything happens. Now, the matter be this, my people, what do you think? Please thumbs up for us, like and share, subscribe, click on the notification button. God bless and bye for now.